We're not going back to the same economy. We're recovering, but to a different economy. And it'll be one that is more leveraged to technology. And I worry that that is going to make it even more difficult than it was for many workers.
In Silicon Valley, and my friends who work in technology know that what we did to the manufacturing workers, we are now going to do to the retail workers, the call center workers, the fast food workers, the truck drivers, and then even bookkeepers, accountants, insurance agents, lawyers, and on through the economy. So what happened to the manufacturing workers is a very clear sign of what's going to happen to these other workers moving forward. And I talked a little bit about...
Welcome to the Crypto Teacher Stock Channel. And guys, please like and subscribe. If you do like what you're listening to, please inform your friends and family and spread all over social media. It is imperative that we get back to learning finances and understand how the world really works. Because once we understand how the world really works, we understand everything is planned out. Now, of course, guys, we go over the funny article first. We have the Warzone prodigy, Call of Duty band, Rowdy Rogan, only 6 years old. Guys, you know I talk about gaming all the time, and it's going to be big. Now, basically, getting over to the news and the actual stocks. Basically, we have Disney stock has been soaring after all those reports of layoffs. That's right, guys. And now also we have Warner Brothers. And guys, I need for y'all to get out and go to the movies. Get out the house, guys. This is what they want to do. Move us over to the fourth industrial revolution. Get out the house. Go to the movies with the family. Because basically Warner Brothers is going to start putting the actual movies on HBO Max as soon as it hit theaters. So, guys, get out, enjoy yourself, the fresh air, the sun. Get out and go to the movies, guys. Don't do what these people want us to do. Now, of course, getting over into the stocks, we have the VIX was up, and, of course, the stock market was down. Now, guys, we're going to get over into the actual stocks that can double. Remember, I'm not your financial advisor. This is not financial advice because one of these stocks are shaky. But it definitely can double your money if you play it right. We have the Canadian Cannabis Sundial has 180 days to get this stocks up, guys. So right now it's in about the 50-cent range. On the NASDAQ, you have to be above a dollar. So yes, you're taking a chance. But of course, cannabis is going into the year with a lot of great news. The second one, guys, is the ETF that I spoke about time and time again. And that is the SPAC ETF. We know how big these SPACs have been. Why not buy the SPAC ETF? But definitely, guys, those stocks can actually double soon. Now, basically, we have the IPO prices going crazy, as we know. The market cap was ridiculous. And, of course, it has raised red flags with everybody. I see it all over social media. Like, you didn't even let the little guy even get a little piece. And now, of course, what did they do, CNBC? Brain Kramer in saying the same thing. And then also Kramer said something very important is start taking some profits. And everybody needs to start doing that. Anytime you invest in anyway, you want to take some profits. Greed will always kill. Now we have Tesla to replace apartment investment and management in the S&P 500. Also, Tesla will join the S&P 100, replacing Occidental Petroleum. So we see that the New World Order is moving around Tesla. Remember, Tesla is a New World Order stock. Now, basically, we have NIO trying to raise $2.5 billion, proposes an offering of 60 million American shares. So, guys, that's the reason why the stock, of course, is lower. But make sure you keep an eye on it and catch the bottom. So, therefore, you can ride it back up to the top or you can short it either one. Now, basically, we also have Exxon cut 700 jobs in Houston. We know how big Exxon is, Rockefeller Company. That's no reason to cut anything. But the fact is, guys, we're going to see a whole lot more layoffs coming in 2021 because who's only left? The big corporations. And we know the big corporations do what? Lay off. And they normally lay off around Thanksgiving and Christmas. But it didn't happen because, of course, what? We got over 20 million plus, and they would look crazy laying off when they made all this money doing the C word. So, of course, they're going to spread it out in 2021. Now we have Oracle moves headquarters to Texas. And guys, we're seeing more and more companies are moving from California to Texas. And they're moving to Texas because of the taxes. They're not just moving California because it's expensive, because we know they already get tax breaks. They're moving to avoid taxes. They know the fact is that basically we're about to run into a storm in 2021. We see the big corporations and the billionaires running to avoid taxes because they know 2021 is going to be a struggle. Remember what Blackstone stated? We're going to go through a whole 10 years with no growth inside the United States. And lastly, guys, this is, should be on my funny news, but basically the Federal Reserve says household net worth hits $123 trillion, a record. Now, of course, guys, they're adding in all this fake money printing that they pumped in with the stocks, so people's 401ks and pensions. So basically, we all know that's fake. We all know eventually they're going to have to shrink liquidity, and all that is going down the tubes. We know it, and they know it. Remember what the new Volcker rule, guys. They can open this up and play with this casino. Nobody has any safety net. The banks don't have any safety net. The people don't have any safety net now. So remember, guys, everything the New World Order does is already planned out. And we're definitely running right into their plan, the Fourth Industrial Revolution, where basically you will own nothing, but you will be happy. But that's all I have for you guys. Don't forget to check out the Crypto Teacher channel, where basically you learn the new economy, also cryptos. Plus, guys, make sure you like and subscribe this channel and spread it everywhere. You have a wonderful day.
Well, it does make sense. I mean, every time cannabis is on the ballot in any state in the union, it tends to win, correct?
That's right. Actually, in this last election, every single state, that, which were five of them, that had cannabis initiatives passed overwhelmingly. And we're talking about states like Mississippi, which, of course, is deeply red and very conservative, and all the way, of course, to other states as well, such as North Dakota and so forth. So it's been an amazing run for cannabis lately, and it certainly is becoming more and more normalized.
Okay, you have a great hub strategy, and it's helped you deliver some incredibly good same-store sales numbers. And you're big in Pennsylvania. Made some acquisitions. Yep. They seem good. Can I expect the same thing to happen in the great state of New Jersey where we are right now?
Well, I mean, New Jersey is certainly hot right now, as the governor and others are poising that state for recreational cannabis measures to come. And really in the Northeast as a whole, we see that region turning on. And for us, really the hub strategy is about, just market opportunity and making sure that we have scale in different hubs as the federal landscape changes, which is changing around us, like we just said. And so it's important to have economies of scale and, again, efficiencies. And it's really all about bringing the best quality products to the customers with that fantastic customer experience. And, you know, the U.S. is a very different market than our friends to the north. And there is real incredible opportunity here as we look at the numbers and the growth trajectory for